guys, I have another service call. I'm over here in Covina. That's California. Okay, here's the map of the store. They claim the walk-in freezer is running warm. So I just got here a little while ago. I was already snooping around to see what the problem is. But I want to show you guys what I found. So here's my store. Or I should say, here is my walk-in freezer. 11A. Gotta find 11A on the rack. Found it already. These are all the systems here. That's 23. So on and so forth. And system 11. System walk-in freezer. So that's my system. Alright, we've got a single here. Single compressor running just that freezer. Hopefully the compressor takes out the benzene oil. Refrigerant, HP80. So this is what I was tearing it apart. What's been going on is it had this happen a couple times already. I'm the first one. This is my first time here. There's been another guy here. What happened was the breaker was tripped. This is to the main breaker for this compressor. So the breaker was tripped. And they reset it. The manager reset it before we walked in the first time. So couldn't really figure out what the compressor, why it tripped. That was the first call. I'm back here on the second call. It's like midnight right now. And the breaker tripped again. So I came, did a little bit of inspection. And I didn't have to look too hard either. That was thing about this call. Okay, so here's my main, and like I said, I just did a little bit of visual inspection of what was going on. And let me see if I can turn on my light. I don't know if I can. But let me get my flashlight. Alright, so I just basically look around for any burn marks. That's a visual inspection. This is a big cluster in here anyways. Look at these wires just running everywhere. It's crazy. I'm surprised there's no any other shorts. But I didn't see any physical shorts around the contactor. So I followed my wires going up, which are these ones right here. They go up through my conduit right here. Come out. I follow that up. I go into my compressor, and I always do a physical look, but look what I found right there. I don't know if you can see that. That's a little bit of a burning mark right there, mounting. So this wire goes up, these two wires here, the little ones, these ones here. I follow these up through this conduit here. Comes all the way across my head cooling fan mode. Well, look what I found here. Nice little short on our hand right there. So we can zoom in on that one. Pretty good. So the short is so bad it popped a hole right through the door. Been vibrating so much, finally popped a hole in that thing. I believe this is it's 208 motor. Yeah, it's 230 motor. So pop the hole, goes to my breaker, so it automatically trips my breaker. So it doesn't do it all the time, it does it every once in a while. When it does, it takes down the entire walk-in freezer. So I don't have a motor like this. I gotta order a motor like this. But what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna cut the wires out wire nut them off, isolate it. I'm gonna repair this and see how that repair this, get that back up in the way it should, so we'll be mounted. And then I'll come back. Go ahead and take care of that. I'll show you. Alright, let's see here. I'm gonna go ahead and gotta make sure that these are tight. Gotta give it to all the new guys out there. Ow! Not too good. So, gotta make sure that these are pretty tight, because if these are loose, they're gonna be arching. Then after a while, you're gonna see a lot of burn marks coming up the wire. It's gonna be like burn all the way to the start. So this thing, this lug has failed. Not tightened all the way, or it can't tighten anymore. So you might have to just replace the whole lug, strip down the wire, or replace the wire. It all depends on how bad it is. So to all the new guys out there, make sure all your electrical connections are very tight. Even the nuts, the brass nuts. And you gotta make sure these have to be brass. You cannot put galvanized in there. Not work. It's not good. You need to have the brass nuts. And all this comes in the pack when you change out a compressor. So anyways, go ahead and get this finished tightened up, which is already pretty good. And nice and tight, not going nowhere. Give these a little snug too, just to make sure. I have the power off, perfect chance. Look at that, see, that's pretty good. Tighten that back up pretty good. Do the next one. And again, this is all for just the new guys. All your wiring and everything is from left to right. So it's L1, L2, L3, everything's left to right. It's never right to left. So if you've got L1, L2, L3, it's talking about L1, L2, L3. Look at that. Got my finger. Alright, so just to let you guys know, got that taken care of, took my wires, nice and safe, and I'm going to order a new motor. So I'm pretty much done. I'm going to go ahead and button it back up, and look where they mounted it. The only place they could have found to mount this dual pressure control, right on the canvas. Didn't mount it anywhere else but here. So I'm gonna put that back on, turn it back on, and we'll get back. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and give these a little bit of a snug on here. Yeah, these are all tight. These are solid. Can't turn these anymore. So, all right, I'm gonna start everything back up. I turned all my breakers off. You just never know. This is ported by defrost. Turn that on. Another defrost, 7A, 7B. Turn that on. Got a little guy right here. Turn that on. Turn the main one on, but before I do that, my meter on there. And then I'll turn this one on. Guys, it just started up. Had it down for probably like 20 minutes. Got a little warm on me, so you know, it's just the load on it. Look at that pipe, look at that vibration on that thing. That's gonna break off for you too, and then you have gas everywhere. That's pretty bad. Put it this side that down. Prevent all that vibration. Alright, got some zip ties. I always carry a little bit of zip ties in my bag. This is my bag. This is my quick service bag. This is the one I carry. Works great. Perfect size. Takes in, good job. If I need anything more, then I'll just go grab my bigger bag. But I carry a couple zip ties here. So I went ahead and zip tied it. Stop that vibration, a little more vibrating. And I zip tied it on the silicone, the existing silicone. That way I won't go copper to copper, metal to copper, just put it on the silicone. I don't have any silicone on me right now. So I went ahead and did that. All right, guys, so we're up and running. Got my amps at 28. Compressor's running good. Again, gonna order that motor, and I am done. Thanks for watching. I got another call behind me. I'm gonna see if I can videotape that. And thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next one.